Here we have an EDC17CP14 from a Volkswagen that came in because this unit won't respond on diagnostics in the car or in the bench. Something is going on that PCB. I found from the customer that they took the cover off for chiptuning or something, and they scratch the board here and here. I can see with my naked eye. And let's flip to the microscope to see what's in there. You can see these scratches. Maybe we have some missing components. I think here. And here, no, here looks like the factory soldering. Okay, let's get rid of the glare. And now we can see better. Let's focus. Okay. I want to clean it first to see what's in there. Looks like here we definitely have a missing component. Maybe some broken traces. I'm gonna measure them. Maybe this one or this one. This. I don't know. Okay, what else? We have here we have a problem. That's a broken trace right here. You can see it's ripped off. Let me find a tweezer, a small tweezer. Okay. Yes. And I think this one also is broken. What's here? Oh, that capacitor is bad also. I don't know why people do that. They are trying to open the case of that ECU, and they don't have the proper tools, or they don't have the proper experience. I don't know. They open the case and now the car won't start. The engine won't start, sorry. Let's zoom in. Okay, I can repair easily this one. I don't know about those traces. And I don't know about this through hole either. Doesn't look too affected, too damaged. Okay, let me search for a donor board or for another ECU. Okay, I found another ECU. It's a good ECU. We can take a look. Here it is. And yes, we have this component missing on our PCB. Maybe this also, I don't know. No, we have this resistor missing. This ECU is good. I don't want to take some components from it. I just want to measure those components and get the parts from a broken board. Here we have a 2.6 kilo ohms resistor. Let's measure again. 2.6 kilo ohms resistor. And for this capacitor, I have to measure it. But to measure it correctly, I want to take it out from the circuit and then I'm gonna measure it and put it back. I'm gonna leave it like that to measure it so we don't lost it. We have 100 nanofarads. 100 nanofarads. Let's wait to cool down a bit. Maybe we'll get some differences reading. Maybe I can put some alcohol to pull it down. And let's read again, let's measure again. In the multimeter is in the capacitance mode. And 100 nanofarads. I'm gonna put it back. Let's apply some flux. So we have to find a 2.6 kilo-ohms resistor and a 100 nanofarads capacitor with the same dimensions. Okay, solder it back. Okay, let's put that ECU aside and I'm gonna try to find the components that I need. Okay, I found the components. Here we have the resistor. Let's stick to the tweezer. Okay, I'm gonna solder it. Let's apply flux. My hot air station keeps making a lot of noises, so I ordered another one. Okay, let's replace the capacitor and then I'm gonna take care of those traces. I found the exact dimensions components and of course the same values. Forgot to apply flux. I'm gonna do it now. And hopefully we can and hopefully we can return to the life this ECU. I'm not gonna measure the traces. I'm gonna scratch those traces with the grinding pen. Just like that. And I'm gonna run two wires to restore them. Let's measure the traces here. Meter in continuity mode. And I'm gonna measure from here to here, or from here. The trace is still good, but partially ripped. I'm gonna restore it. This one is looking better. This one has a deep trench. Okay, the traces are not fully broken. but just in case I wanna redo them. I want to test this resistor. I don't know why it is scratched. I want to test again. Resistance mode. Test from here to here. Okay, 2.6 kilohms. Very good. And this is done. This is done. Now I wanna connect to it on the bench. So I'm gonna switch to the other camera. Okay, I have the VCDS connected. I'm gonna save, select ECU, engine control unit. Okay, I think I switched the CAN pins. Let's try again. No, not central electric. Yes. Yes. You can see. Oh, it's mirrored. The image is mirrored. I can read the fault codes, it's connected. I can erase the fault codes. And I can read all the data I want. So, that's fixed. I'm gonna assemble this unit and send it to the customer.
And
that's it for this video. I'm gonna send this unit to the customer and I'm gonna work on something else now.